Welcome back. In the video number 10 of CodeAssist tutorial, we learn what local and global variables are and how to declare and use them. In this video, I'm going to talk about another type of variable in CodeAssist called remnant, how to use persistent global variable list and retain variables in CodeAssist when you want to keep the value of variable after an uncontrolled termination. We will also learn how to declare and use a constant variable. Normally, variable value are kept in a RAM, which means that their value will be lost whenever a termination happens, such as in the event of a power failure. This is usually not a problem for most values, since they will be read automatically from the I/O devices when the program is restarted. Both local and global variables that we have already learned are reinitialized in this way between two executions of the application. The program gets loaded again and the variables are set with predefined values. This means that, for example, counter value stored in this kind of variables is lost if we reboot the controller. But certain values, such as process set points, must be maintained regardless of any interruption. To solve such a problem in CodeAssist, we can use remnant variables. Remnant variables can retain data longer than usual. For this purpose, we can use a persistent global variable list or retain variables. Let's see how we can use these variables in CodeAssist programming. I've already declared a local and a global variable with two counters. Variable start to enable the counters. Current value of the first counter will be stored in the local variable var1. And for the second counter, I have used the global variable var2. Log in and start the simulation. With each edge of the start, the counter current value will be incremented by 1. Now assume we have a power loss, restart of the PLC, or redownload of the program. The current value will be 0. I'm going to do a warm reset. As you see, all the variables are initialized. Now I want to make these two local and global variables retain to keep the values. To do that, just select the variable and from edit, click on auto declare to bring back this window for the variable. Here we can set the variable constant, retain and persistent. So I will select retain here and hit OK. As you see, the variable is moved to the var retain area, so this variable will retain its value. Let's do the same for counters and global variable. Because our variable is global, you see here var global retain. Download the change. Now the current value has changed and I want to do a warm reset. On restarting the program, the system continues to operate with the stored values and the variables retain their values. Let's try a cold reset. What do you think? Can the variable keep their values? No, called reset made the reset of the variable's value. So even if we use the retain variable in codices with a called reset or reset origin, the value will be reinitialized. If you need to keep the value even with the called reset, you can use the second option called persistent variable. To make a variable persistent, we need to have a special variable list in our program where all the persistent variables are listed. Do a right click on the application and add persistent variable list. It looks like we have added a global variable list. Now we need to declare our variable inside this list. For our local variables, open autodeclare and select persistent. For the global variable, do the same. For global variables, there is a difference that we must select our persistent list for the object. As you see, when I select persistent, the global variable list is not selectable as an object anymore. The variable is moved to the persistent list. In the main program, we need also to redefine the path. The variable is not in global variable list anymore. It's in persistent vars. We need to do one more thing. Click on generate code. As you see, codices says there is no matching instance path in the persistent list. This happens because these variables are local and they are unknown to the persistent list. To add the path, write the name of the program that we have declared local variables with a point. And then select the variable. Do the same for other variables. Now if you generate the code, you see we have no error or warning. We could also declare the variable inside the persistent list and then change the path inside the main program, exactly like what we did with the global variable. Let me do this for one of the variables. We don't need this variable anymore. Then I can delete PLCPRG as the path of the counter 2 inside the persistent list. But we need to write the path inside the main program. I prefer to use persistent variables in this way because when we declare a variable locally in a program or function and with an instance path in the persistent variable list, the variable takes more places in memory. It lies in the protected memory area and also in the memory of the controller with double allocation. In my opinion, for big projects, it's better not to do that. Now download the change. I'm going to do a warm reset. All the variables keep their values. And also a cold reset. The The values are not reinitialized and the variables still have their values even with the cold reset. And that's the difference between retained variable and persistent. Retained variables retain their values with just a warm reset. Codices reinitialize these variables in the case of reset origin, reset cold, and a repeated program download. Persistent variables retain their values in the case of a reset cold, a repeated download of the application, and a reset warm. Codices reinitialize persistent variables only in the case of a reset origin. The next point about this kind of variables is when we want to make some change in our variables. Let me change some persistent variables and re-download the program to see what happens. I'm going to change the counter 1 to up and down counter and the type of the local var 1 to double word. Download the change. As you see, Codices says we have changed these variables and they will get the initial values. I forgot to change the variables here. Global var2 has still its value, but local var1 is now 0. Each time the application is reloaded, Codices compares the persistent variable list on the controller with that of the project. In case of inconsistencies, Codices requests you to reinitialize all persistent variables before the download, which leads to loss of persistence. Inconsistency results from the renaming or deleting or some other chains of existing persistent variables declarations. So if you make a frequent change due to what you have in your application, such a list is not recommended in principle. It would be better to declare them as retained variables with the retained keyword only. Okay, at the end, I want to talk about constant variables. This kind of variable you can declare in global variable list or the declaration part of programming objects as local. An important thing about constant variables is that they are constant and we have access as just read-only variables. It means we cannot change the value inside our program after that we have declared it. Open the autodeclare window. I'm going to declare a variable of type integer. I want it to be a local variable inside this object PSC-PRG and select here constant. Here we need to write the initialization value. Hit OK. A new var area is created here as a constant variable. Let me use an assignment and assign a value to this variable. As you see, Codices does not accept this. Create another integer variable as a normal variable and with the same initialization. Login. Try to write a value here, because it says this variable cannot be forced or written. But we can do it for this variable. As you see, we could read and write the value of the normal variable, but the constant variable is read-only. You see also here a little c. It means this variable is a constant variable. You can use a constant variable where you don't need to change the value in your program. Alright, that was another video of Codices tutorial. I hope that could improve your programming skills with Codices. See you next video. Bye!